This is outside of, I think it's called Ember Shard Mine. I'm trying out the attraction mod that I'm using. See if my character likes Feyndall at all, or if he likes me at all.
I've got your back. What do you need? Let me know.
Because I've tried different. There's all kinds of relationship mods for Skyrim. There's mods based on relationship, as far as your relationship rank with another character. Are you guys acquaintances, allies, friends, lovers? Rivals, foes, enemies, you know, that kind of thing. Then there's another relationship, and that's the attraction one. Like, does your character's race like other races, you know, kind of thing? You representing your entire race, do you like this kind of race or this other kind of race? Would you ever date someone outside your race? Are you okay with all races? You know, that kind of thing. You can. So it's race baiting. And then there's, what's the other one? The arousal. From 0 to 100, I think. Yeah, from 0 to 100. That's your arousal. Sometimes you don't care what someone's rank is with you. You know, you don't care if they're an enemy.
You need to not bother me.
Or your best friend. If you got the hots for someone, that's good enough. Sometimes if you're not attracted to someone, but you're in heat, your character's in heat. Your character doesn't care how ugly the other person is sometimes. And vice versa, NPCs think the same way about your character, so it just adds this whole kind of dynamic. Instead of just pluses and minuses, or if then or kind of logic, you know, the binary. Out of the box, Skyrim comes with binary. You're either for or against us, you know, kind of a thing. They either like or they don't like you. They either trust or they don't trust you. But thanks to these mods you can download, it adds gray lines to everything. It blurs. The truth and the lies are blurred. So you can get away with doing things that normally you wouldn't be able to do only because you're hot.
Need something?
Because attraction will actually alter relationships you have with other NPCs.
Like every farmer in Skyrim is short on supplies these days.
I mean, if a guy finds you super attractive, and you're inside his house,
yes,
he might let you take everything he owns.
Until next time.
Clean out his whole entire house.
Need something?
Without stealing. If someone doesn't like how you look, they may never say hi to you. You may never get anything for free from that person. So it's just different. So I mean, at this point I was tweaking the mods to the point where I was pulling my hair out. No, I'm joking. I was just tweaking the mods to make it fit for the type of Skyrim game I want to play in this playthrough. That makes immersive sense. And still retains its... You know, I've said this before. I'm a fanatic when it comes to Skyrim-ish. I want my game to remain Skyrim. I don't want it to turn into a whole other kind of game. I want to feel like I'm still playing Skyrim when I have all these mods installed.
Walk away, now.
Walk away, now.
There are times where I'm able to rescue the prisoner from whatever guards are taking them somewhere. But I don't have a Dremora. Because what will happen is, if I talk to the prisoner and say, hey, I'm going to help you escape, and he's like, oh, cool. He always dies. He always gets killed. So if I don't talk to the prisoner at all, if I just start whacking on the three guards, they won't try to fight the prisoner at all. They'll only be trying to fight me. So when they're all dead, then the prisoner's like, he runs off. He doesn't even thank me. He just runs off to wherever it is he belongs to. Which is fine, because, you know, I'm saving the guy. I don't need to become a legend in my own mind. Or a time, or whatever it is. Legend in my own time. And that was weird. I saw the mad woman just run past me. Or a crazed woman. So that's an encounter that's broke already in my game. Normally she stops and says, with that stupid voice of hers, she'll say something like, I barely escaped from some bandits that kidnapped me. Here, let me mark it on your map. I cannot run as fast as her. Where's she going? Or she'll say something like, I escaped some vampires. Do you have any health potions? Or do you have something that will cure my disease? So now she won't say anything to me. And I know she doesn't belong here.
Yes.
If that happens, though, the person she's supposed to meet with...
Well, that's taken care of. No thanks to you.
That person probably got killed. And so
certainly
that...
not.
The crazed woman has no one to talk to.
The opportunity to take on a giant. That's why I'm here, with my shield brothers. An outsider, eh? Never heard of the Companions? An order of warriors. We are brothers and sisters in honor. And we show up to solve problems if the coin is good enough. Not for me to say. You'll have to talk to Kodlak Whitemane up in Yurvaskar. The old man's got a good sense for people. He can look in your eyes and tell your worth. If you go to him, good luck.
Has he been lollygagging?
Come to Yurvaskar. And be a companion.
Spending too much time not in Whiterun. I'm trying to get him to turn around. Stand still so I can see if he likes me. He really likes me, kind of a thing. But I don't know if he does. I can't read the
There's a nip in the air.
Teeny weeny print.
Good for my crops. Never is.
But yeah, so the longer I wait coming over here, the more encounters that overlap each other. So you end up with a broken encounter like I do sometimes where you know, maybe there was like a fight scene with some wolves and an encounter gets broken because the wolves killed the encounter before I got to it, so I only see half the story.
Just north by the Laurier's farm. Fool had a coffin in a cart with a broken wheel. I'd like to see him laugh his way out of that.
Well, sounds like you've had quite the journey, Uthgard. But you were gone longer than usual. I got to think you maybe
So I've got an Uthgard overhaul. Basically, it's a new Barbie doll head that I've snapped on her body. I went on Nexus and did a search for NPC overhauls. And of course that filled up my ESP slots, so now I'm up to 254 ESPs, and that's it. I can't add any more.
City's closed with the dragons about. Official business only. Or else what? You think you can stand against the entire Whiterun City Guard? The gate's closed. Fine. But we'll be keeping an eye on you.
Anyway, so I specifically came here because I wanted to touch base with that follower that I installed in my last playthrough.
If the news from Helgen is true,
Livia.
Well, there's no telling what it means.
I want to start my game
the commander of the guard here
with her.
I only counsel caution. We cannot afford to act rashly in times like these. My lord, please, you have to listen. If the news from Helgen is true, well, there's no telling what it means.
Scat!
I only counsel caution. We cannot afford to act rashly in time.
Ain't nobody high and mighty in these halls, except in the Jarl. And don't you forget.
A lot of the women hate me because I'm prettier. I'm prettier than them.
What would you have me
do? What's the meaning of this interruption? Jarl Balgruuf is not receiving visitors.
This is no time for rash.
And that's not the kind of setting I want. I don't want a setting where all the women in Skyrim hate me.
Want to speak to you personally.
Who's this then?
So I had to go and do some minor adjustments to the attraction mod.
You saw this dragon with your own eyes?
Because if women hate you, you don't get anything done.
It's you! I knew you made it out of Helgen alive! That dragon had no chance of stopping you! Don't play coy. I know who you are. That prisoner of Helgen. You see, I have been searching around Skyrim for you. Just when I was ready to give up and return for Cyrodiil, here you are. Do you truly not remember me? Okay, I suppose it's only fair that I tell you why I was finding you. Now, I need you to stay calm while you listen to me. You being captured at Darkwater Crossing and sent to Helgen for execution, it was my doing. Thank you for your calmness. I was ordered by my hire, a woman who goes by the alias The Mistress, to lure a specific person to Darkwater Crossing, then capture them. I did not know why, but orders were orders. I had to uphold my honor.
Okay, she goes on for like 20 minutes. But when the rubber hits the road, she draws a blank. She won't follow me. There's no option. I'm like, what the hell? Does she hate me that much? Am I that beautiful that she refuses to follow me? Because that's a thing in my game, if I'm not careful with my attraction settings. I'll alienate everyone in the game. They won't have anything to do with me. So the option to follow me is not an option anymore. Meanwhile, I thought I'd go out here.
Will be to keep an eye out and get the people to safety if the town is attacked. I don't expect the three of you to fight off a dragon by yourselves, but I do expect you to do your duty.
Of course. We'll keep Riverwood safe. You can count on it. Let's move out. Time's a wasting.
Mm-hmm.
Good talking to you.
If you have need of hunting supplies, then you've come to the right place.
So I decided I would use this guy as a follower instead.
Let's not waste any time.
I'll be happy to assist you if you'd like to purchase something.
Hey! Let's get going. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
I want to say this guy's done by someone named Liadys? L-I-A-D-Y-S?
Blade and shadow, you have need of silence supplies. And death.
Then you've come
These
to the right
are
place.
My art. For a modest fee.
So I downloaded a few followers from that author. Downloaded a few head replacers for some of the NPCs that I thought, they could probably use a different face in my game. What do they call those things? Facelifts? There's a facelift mod out there, so I downloaded maybe 5 or 6 more heads. Anyway, so my character tends to like this one, so I thought, what the heck. Let's go adventuring and see what happens.